Hi guys.
Oh gosh. We're back to answer all your questions. We're gonna try answering most of them right now. It's really sweaty, so I'm a girl with sweaty veins.
So keep DMing us.
Sorry, JV is a little bit sleepy. He had a night shift. He just woke up. All right, you ready for question number one? I don't know if I should say their names because I might say them wrong. KK Gatson _. What are some of your best achievements you have accomplished together?
What, babe?
I'm gonna say staying at the Zulik in Tulum.
That's
that was one
big.
Of our goals. We write our New Year's resolutions every year in a piece of paper, and we frame them and put it in the kitchen so we see it every day. Mm-hmm. And that was one of our goals. Mm.
My biggest achievement is yet to come.
Oh my gosh, you keep telling people that. What's the most unforgettable thing together?
The time you farted in your sleep.
I didn't fart in my sleep.
You did.
You don't have any proof.
It was the first.
You don't have any proof.
And only time.
How do you remember that? You're probably half asleep.
I think a guy would remember when his girl farts for the first time. So, on to the next.
What was your first impression of each other? Oh, I forgot to say your name. Mitt XLYN.
First impression.
Mm-hmm.
You were race face.
I
softball uniform.
Do you remember my braces?
I do.
What? No, you don't.
First impression.
Well, you were like 10, you were playing video games, so I didn't have
I was digging it. You're over there eating your pizza, and you went to drink your soda, you're like...
Alright. What are the pros and cons of a long-term relationship? I mean... Bro, long term, when you get married, have babies, and live with that person, and grow together, and it's like awesome.
Cons.
You can't go on Tinder anymore.
No more Bumble. Sorry.
I've never been on any dating website ever.
Me neither.
What?
So I don't know what swipe right means.
I saw your POF account and your emails.
Plenty of fish.
Oh gosh. How old are you? Old enough to not be on his insurance plan for my parents.
26. Straight answer.
No. That came from 18_2, 1992. How was your first date?
First date?
I took him out on the first date.
No, she didn't.
That did.
No,
we
I
went
took
after school, and I drove my mom's car, and we went to Pinkberry, or Berry Pool. After school.
I'm pretty sure I paid.
I don't know. Maybe
pretty sure I paid.
I don't know.
Yeah, I paid.
We went on a lot of first dates.
I paid. Yeah.
And then our other kind of date was In-N-Out, but I paid.
That was because the drive-thru window was on her side.
I still paid, so it technically wasn't a date. What was, like, our official
but
date?
But you used up my gas, and I paid for my gas, so
you
I still paid for something
on my
bill.
You took me to a bar in Newport.
Because I like to get lit.
Yeah, that's not a date. what do you both eat for breakfast, Rock Santa?
Breakfast
is my favorite meal. Mm. I wake up and ask him what he wants for breakfast.
Before work, I do a protein shake. That's it. On the weekends, I will do like eggs, bacon, hash browns.
No, you won't.
If we go out to eat, because I don't like that.
You never
cook. I don't cook.
We post-made breakfast.
We do post-made breakfast. So when we go out to eat, that's what I do.
We love Seabird's breakfast in Costa Mesa and Long Beach. And what other breakfast places are there?
really go there because she's the vegan.
So. We like Wide Eyes Open. It's a coffee shop in Long Beach of the best toast.
And coffee.
And coffee.
And that's about it.
Yeah.
Those are places we hit up in Long Beach.
What else? What do you like most about each other? His tongue.
What? That's dirty, dude. Oh, man. Why do you like my tongue so much?
Because it's pretty.
Oh, pretty good. Dirty. Dirty birdie.
All right, I gotta go. I gotta take care of some business. No. You're so nice. You're nice to everybody.
I'm just friendly.
You help old people walk the street, open the doors for them.
That's unrealistic.
You carry their bags. You're just so sweet.
I hold the door open.
You're
I don't carry their bags.
He doesn't
kiss
you.
No, I didn't.
You're kind of feminine, and I like it.
Kind of feminine?
Yeah.
What's feminine
like,
about me?
I kill the spiders, because you're scared.
There's nothing feminine about that. That's a phobia. I don't like spiders.
Like, be manly.
No, there's nothing not manly about it. I hate spiders, and that's a phobia.
It's awesome that you like to do laundry.
Because I like clean clothes. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, guys are limited on clothing. All right.
Like, what do you like most about me?
I like your personality. You have the best personality.
Stop lying. That wasn't a good answer.
I like that you do all this Instagram stuff so you can buy me nice things.
Yes. Yes. What was the cutest date you guys ever went on? Plus, tips for relationship advice. _Tori with like a million eyes. I'm going to say Paris.
Paris?
Yeah. We were in Venice and we randomly booked a flight for one day to go to Paris. And we were on the Eiffel Tower by ourselves. It was completely empty and it was awesome. Mm-hmm. I felt like I was on The Bachelor.
And they have the best breakfast though.
Yes. Coffee. Mm-hmm.
Leche.
Is that your favorite date?
That was my favorite date.
Relationship tips. Basically everyone, we got a lot of questions on that, so.
Let me see. If she's vegan and you're not vegan, don't ask her out. I'm just kidding.
I'm gonna say keep it interesting. Sacrifices.
Flowers at least once a month.
Mm-hmm.
Guys,
communication.
Remember, Red Week is Head Week.
Yes, and I'm gonna say mainly sacrifices because you have to like not be selfish in a relationship, and that was hard for me. So I'm kind of selfish. So
and stubborn.
But yeah, keep it interesting.
Keep things interesting. You know.
Have fun.
Date nights, sex
date
nights,
all the time.
Netflix can chill.
Even though we don't watch any Netflix.
Because we're doing the chilling part.
How many times have you guys split up, Hazel, Jane? Never. What's up? It's like your first relationship where you don't
split up. Huh?
What? this is for JB, Hazel, Jane again. Hey man, what's your favorite sleeping position?
Sleeping position. I sleep where I'm facing away from Autumn, so that if I do fart, she feels the vibrations of it.
Sometimes I like it.
Sound like this.
How do you deal with fights or disagreements in your relationship? Samantha, twist.
Autumn doesn't talk to me for 24 hours.
I lock him in the bedroom. I mean, he doesn't come in the bedroom.
Yeah.
I lock the bedroom door. Yeah. That's only happened twice, though. Because he didn't come home from a party.
And I just chose to sleep on the couch because we have a spiral staircase and it's hard to walk up there.
You know what? You gotta let them party with the guys sometimes.
Duh.
But at least let me know when
sacrifices.
You're gonna come home.
Did you not just talk about sacrifices?
But you don't text me if you're gonna come home or not.
Because I'm drunk.
Anywho. That's why you buy them an Apple Watch so you get the text messages on your watch and your phone. No excuses.
Apple Watch.
How do you two handle distance being apart for long times? Leah_York.
How do you handle distance?
This week has been pretty hard just because you work night shifts now and we both actually have jobs, which a lot of you don't know. So by the time I get home, you're already gone, or when you get home, I'm already gone. I think staying busy and going out with your friends and going to the gym and working out and doing you and having a beauty night, doing a face mask, and thank God for my doggy.
Wind down.
Company. And I definitely need a pillow that's the shape of your body so I go to sleep now at night.
It's going to be a big pillow. So mine would be gym, gaming, and Pornhub.
Oh my gosh. Okay. What are your favorite foods? Yaz, Andy. What's my favorite food? You get this wrong.
Ube.
That's like a dessert.
You can use it as food.
My favorite food's Thai.
I know it is. Thai?
Thai food.
I know, Pad Thai. Gosh, you guys, I didn't know that. What's my favorite food?
Pizza.
Pizza is food? No. It's not pizza. She thinks it's pizza. It's pizza.
Okay.
And In-N-Out.
How do you know you love someone? Nana Obi.
How do you know you love someone? When you drunk text them saying you love them, and then that you want to be with them all the time, and then when they're sober, they're still saying all that stuff.
It worked.
Drunken words are sober thoughts.
How do you keep the fire burning in your relationship?
Well, I'm not a firefighter, I'm a policeman, so.
Ooh, you just told them your job.
There ain't no fire to put out.
I would say to keep things interesting, to play games.
Games? Like, elaborate.
Like sexual games.
Ooh. Like by lingerie.
Yeah.
Teasing. Let's be teased.
Go out a lot.
Go out and have your date nights, wind down. Drink a few old fashions.
And if you're tired, to go do stuff.
Yeah. I don't think that was directed towards me.
How tall are you and how tall is JB? Andy Wilson. I am 5'2".
I am 6'8". Well guys, if you have any more questions, just feel free to DM Autumn. Or me, I guess.
And we'll answer most of them and all of them. I mean, I'm sorry. And we'll answer most of them.
Why not all of them?
Okay, fine. We'll try and answer all of them. They're asking us for relationship advice, and you're like sassy with me right now.
Yes, more relationship advice, and I'll be more serious.
He hasn't ate all day, so we're about to go eat dinner after this.
A little bit.
And he will be.
We're gonna go get a tummy.
Thank you for watching.